This tutorial looks at the playback mode and the cue list. We'll discuss the advanced settings of the cue list. We'll talk about the settings of the chases in another tutorial. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, and welcome to this tutorial. To learn more about the various parts of the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, keyboard, and screen, you are advised to watch Tutorial 1 and 2, Hardware and Software. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the chimp hardware keys as keys and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. Opening cue list settings. To look at the settings of the cue list, we first have to open a cue in the cue list view split widget. We open Cue List 7 by tapping on Playback Label 5 on the screen. This cue list contains 4 cues. We select the Settings menu by tapping on the Settings button in the upper toolbar. Next to the Link Select button in the upper toolbar, which we looked at in another tutorial, we see two buttons called the Load Default and Save Default buttons. All the settings of the cue list can be stored with the Save Default function so that we can apply the Load Default button later to use these settings in other cue lists. In the Settings overview, we have the Options Cue List and Chase. We will deal with chases in another tutorial. Cue List Settings. In our example, we start Cue 5 by sliding Fader 5 upwards. In the settings, we can see the tracking option. By tapping on this button, we can choose from various possibilities. Tracking is set to Enabled by default, which means that all recorded values of cues are included in the subsequent cues in the cue list. In our example, we set tracking to disabled. We press playback key 5 to activate the next cue in the list. Since tracking is set to disabled, the information is not included in cue 2. No dimmer value is included, and we see nothing in the visualizer. Only cue 1 contains dimmer information. If we set tracking to enabled again, we see that the information is included and the dimmer is activated. In the pull-down menu, we also see enabled plus track through end. This setting will track all values from the last cue into the first cue. Next to the tracking, we see the priority settings. The priority settings are relevant when we play several cues together. Dimmer HTP stands for Highest Takes Priority. This means that the cue with the highest DMX value has priority. LTP High Priority stands for Latest Takes Priority. This means that the cue that is last activated has a higher priority regardless of the DMX value in this cue. If the LTP function is activated, we can see this from the cue list icon, which displays the letters HI. The next setting we'll look at is Run Mode. We can use the Run Mode to configure how to go through the cue list. If the loop at end function is chosen, the cue list starts with the first cue again, when it reaches the end and continues until an off command is given. The release at end function ensures that the cue list stops at the last cue, and is then deactivated. And the stop at end function ensures that the queue list stops at the last queue and the queue list remains active. Next to the run mode is the release time function. This function is used to set the time used by the chimp to fade out the last active queue when the queue is deactivated. We'll set the release time to 2 seconds. When we now deactivate the active queue, we can see that it takes the chimp 2 seconds to do so. We can see this release time by the yellow color on the fader label. The next function is the fade master. This is set to default, queue timing, by default. This means that the fade time that is configured in the queue list under the setting in fade is used. By tapping on the fade master button on the screen, we can choose from a variety of options. We can select percentages or seconds for the fade times between the queues, but we can also opt for a master fader. If we select a master fader 1 in our case, we can use a fader to set the fade time between the queues. In our case, we set the fade master function back to default, queue timing. If we make use of effects in a queue, we can influence them by choosing an effect speed master or an effect size master. The speed and size of the effect will then be controlled by the master faders. In our example, we restore it to the default setting of none as we have not programmed any effects. Underneath, you can see various off options, which we can check or uncheck. The first option is skip to first queue on off. When this function is activated, the queue list will always return to the first queue in the queue list after an off command. If this function is switched off, then the queue list will remain at the queue where it received the off command. The next option is ignore off all commands. In our example, we turn on the ignore off all commands by tapping on the box. If this is activated, then this queue will not be switched off if an off all command is given. We will activate various queues. We press the infinity key and the off key to give the off all command and see that all queue lists are switched off, except for the queue lists for which the ignore off all commands has been enabled. If we switch off ignore off all commands in our queue list and then give the off all command, we see that the queue list is also switched off. The final function is off if overwritten. If this function is activated, then the queue list will be switched off when there is another queue list active in which the same attributes are programmed. In our example, we created virtual executors with different colors. These are activated when virtual executor 1 is pressed. If we then press virtual executor 2, we see that virtual executor 1 is switched off. This is because the value of virtual executor 1 is overwritten with the value of virtual executor 2. In the queue list view split widget, we see that the off if overwritten function is switched on. We switch off the off if overwritten function in the queue list settings. We now see that if another virtual executor is selected, this one is not switched off. If we switch the off if overwritten function back on, we see that virtual executor 4 is switched off again if another virtual executor is activated. The last part of the queue list settings relates to the timecode options. The use of the timecode function is discussed in a separate tutorial. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its chimp-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the chimp.